But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. The beautiful words of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to his disciples and to you and me today. My name is Brian Mashigadi. Welcome to Life Series. We read today from the book of Acts chapter 1, from verse 8, and I'm going to read, and it says, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." This is a beautiful portion of scripture that reminds us of the words of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that just before he ascended to heaven, towards the last days after his resurrection, he's gathered together with the disciples and he's speaking to them. What is he saying to them? He's telling them, do not leave Jerusalem, tarry until I send you the Holy Spirit. Of course, the promise of the Holy Spirit that he had already given to them in the book of John chapter 14, as he's speaking to them, he tells them, I'm not going to leave you as orphans in verse 18. Says to them, I'm not going to leave you as orphans, but I shall come to you. Says, I'm going to send you another helper. I'm going to send you the Holy Spirit. What a beautiful thing. This is how I like to think about the person of the Holy Spirit. Jesus Christ walked on the earth for about 33 years, give or take. Yeah. And as Jesus was walking across or along or in the earth, as Jesus was treading the earth, he saw many things. He was fully God and fully man at that time. So he's been born, he's gone through the whole human experience. But at the time of his departure, as he's speaking to the disciples, he's not saying to them, I'm going to give you land, I'm going to give you gold, I'm going to give you money, I'm going to give you relationships. No, that's not what he says to them. Not that these things are bad, no, not at all. But he's speaking to them and saying to them, I will send you the Holy Spirit. As if Jesus were to imply, walk with me, as if Jesus were to imply that of all the things that would be necessary in this day and age in the earth, the Holy Spirit is top of that list. That without the Holy Spirit, the believer is not able to walk. Without the Holy Spirit, the believer is not able to work. Without the Holy Spirit, the believer is not able to be productive. The believer is not able to be witnesses in Jerusalem, in the place where they are first, before they go outside there. Many times we have this example and we say people don't accept us when they are around us, people who know us, people around home, and so on and so forth. Guess who makes that possible? The Holy Spirit, who's been promised. So who is the Holy Spirit? Our helper. That's who he is. In times of despair, he's our comforter. In times where we are confused, he's our counselor. In times where we don't know what to do, he's our teacher. Everything that the Master was here on earth, the Holy Spirit is. Jesus says to us, I will send you another helper, another of the same kind. The Holy Spirit. What shall he do? Shall teach you all things, lead you into all truth. He shall encourage you, counsel you, comfort you, and the list is endless. I don't know about you, but that's a person I want to know more and more about. Not just today, but every day until I am taken up together to be with Jesus in eternity. So we invite you as we share in the next coming weeks, that as we share about the person of the Holy Spirit, the fruit that we are supposed to bear, the fruit of the Holy Spirit, and many other things about him. I need him, you need him too. The Holy Spirit, without him, you can do nothing. But with him, oh man, you can do everything. God bless you.